Hey everyone, Steve here from SJ Woodworks. I've seen a lot of videos online of people making spinning tops on the lathe, and I think they're a lot of fun, and you know, I've made a couple of small spinning tops, but I wanted to go one step further and make a big jumbo size spinning top today. So I've got an oak dowel here about 1.25 inches in diameter, and I've got a disc of, I don't know what kind of wood this is. It looked brown when I started. I cut it into a disc, and it's got some interesting purple grain in here, so I don't know what it is, but let's see what happens. We're going to try and turn this into a big jumbo size spinning top on the lathe today. So let's give it a shot. Okay, let me just fill you in a little bit on what I've done. So I chucked my oak dowel up here between centers. I wanted to put it in a chuck on this end, but it's just a little bit too big. 1.25 inch is just a tiny bit too big for the pin jaws on my chuck. So I've turned this end down just a tiny bit for a tenon that will fit in the chuck for later. And then I trued the whole thing up because it's not quite exactly on center when I put it between centers here. This is an oak dowel that I just picked up from Lowe's, really, from my local big box hardware store. So it's not going to be the highest quality oak that I've ever turned. I don't know how clean it's going to be when it's done, but I'm not too worried about that, frankly. I think it's going to look good no matter what, even if it's got these grain lines in it and stuff that aren't perfectly smooth. We'll see how that comes out. But what I need to do is turn this down on this end to equal the hole that I drilled into my wood here. So I've got to be able to put this on here right about here, maybe. So I need to make a tenon that's pretty long and that's exactly the size so I can squeeze this in there and glue it in. And that's going to be a trick. It might not be the cleanest thing. I'm going to try and think about best ways to do this. But for now, I'm just going to turn down a nice tenon here, stick this thing on, and glue it in place so we can finish making the top once we get this end chucked in. So let's go for it. Alright, I'm going to catch up to where I am here. So I turned a small tenon down here and chucked it up just in my 1-inch jaws here because it's just a dowel. Then, like I said, I turned this down on this side to the right diameter, and I put it into... I mounted this piece and glued it on. I just used CA glue. Wood glue would be better. In this case, maybe Gorilla glue would be even better because it would do some gap filling. But then on this side of this main piece of wood, there was a little gap between this and the dowel on this side. So I guess my drill press wasn't totally running true when I drilled the hole in this. So I got another small piece of wood here that I think is maybe Babinga or something like that. I drilled a hole in that and I wedged this on here as tight as I could, and I think this gap is less than the gap that I had before. So this is going to be even better, I guess, than it was before. It's still not perfect. Again, wood glue would be better than CA glue for this, I guess. I don't have the patience, and I'm actually not sure where my wood glue is at the moment. But so this piece now is going to become the point of my top. This piece is going to become the spinning part. I think it's going to be big enough we got to spin it with our hands. But now I think we're to the point where we can just kind of turn the handle and turn this piece and kind of smooth this transition out and make a top out of it. Now the transition from this piece to this piece to this dowel is not going to be perfect. There are going to be gaps there I can see already. So we're just going to do our best with that and ignore it when it's done, and hopefully you won't even be able to see it on camera, and I will fake it. So there you go. Let's get turning. Thank you. Okay, so I did some sanding, and I sanded just down to 220. There are some chips in the oak, along the oak grain here, just from this being an old dried oak dowel. Not the highest quality oak, because I just got it from my local Lowe's. That's okay. I've decided to kind of embrace some of the defects in the wood there. There's also along here, I'm going to turn this off so maybe you can see it. There's some beetle holes here and stuff that I've decided to leave in that I could have, you know, made this just a tiny bit smaller and gotten rid of those, but I've decided to just kind of embrace some of that stuff and sand it down to 220. The gap here actually is mostly closed between this babinga and this whatever this is, so I'm okay with that. I'll confess that surface should have been better prepared. It should have been better, you know, flattened and sanded for that glue joint, but I wasn't expecting to put that piece on at all until there was a bigger gap between this and the dowel. Now we got to work on getting this thing off. I brought this down close to a point. I need to get this parted off on this side. It's going to stay in the chuck over on that side that you can't see right now off the screen. But I'm going to part this off, get rid of this thing, and then I'm going to put something else here in the live center to give this point some support without damaging it while we work on parting it off down on that end. So I'm going to get this parted off. I'm just going to use the Diamond Detail carbide tool from Easy Wood Tools to just finish off that point and get it parted off on this side while I support it with my other hand. And then we'll turn it off, the chuck will hold it, and I'm going to put something else here. I'll show you how that's going to work. Okay, I'm going to remove this live center here. It's already pretty much off the screen, but let's get that out. And I'm going to put in a live center that I usually use when I'm turning pens, and the mandrel goes inside of there to keep the mandrel from getting bent. So basically, it's just hollow all the way through in this live center here. I'm just going to let that support the point here while I carry on with the rest of this. But I am going to put a couple of layers of paper towel, maybe a few layers of paper towel there to keep it from getting too scratched up on that end. I just want it to support this on this side while I work on it over on this side. I don't know if you noticed, after I parted this off, I was withdrawing the tool, I actually nicked this right here. You can see a little dig right here. I mean, it was a catch. Just as I was pulling the tool away, I wasn't paying attention, I just caught it really quick. So before we go on, I'm going to smooth that down, because that's an imperfection in the wood that I caused, and that's different than embracing the imperfection in your wood. I'm going to fix that error just by rounding this in just a little tiny bit more. Totally my carelessness there. Okay, I think we got that little gouge fixed there. Just, you know, took just a sh shaved a little tiny bit more off of there and did some sanding again to get that back down. So I think we're okay there. Now we need to finish this off on this end by parting here and putting a nice end on it. And I'm going to use this diamond detail again from Easy Wood Tools to try to just kind of shape an end of the handle here that looks okay, I think, and then we'll part it off, and you know, and we'll do some sanding before we totally part it off, just on this end so it looks okay. Then we're going to part the whole thing off, and I'm just going to finish it with a coat of Danish oil, maybe a couple of coats of Danish oil, to finish it off. So let's get that going. Okay, we got it off. I'm gonna finish off this end here off the lathe, and then we'll put some oil on it. So I brought the camera onto the back of the workbench here. So I got this off the lathe, and I finished up this end here. So basically, what we've got here is, again, just an oak dowel. It was a 1¼-inch dowel when I started. I probably could have started with one quite a bit smaller. Did a little spindle turning here, a couple of coves and a bead here. I've been forcing myself to practice to do some spindle turning because I'm terrible at beads and coves and things like that. But I think it came out okay considering it's just an oak dowel. So some of the oak grain shows here and isn't completely smooth. There are a couple of chips from the oak grain, but it's not bad actually, better than I thought it was going to be. This disc here, you saw me hollow this out here and here. I don't know what kind of wood it is. I was not expecting to see any of this purple grain. I'm curious to see what it looks like when the Danish oil goes on. This little piece here, I think, is Babinga, and then this is the end of the oak dowel again. Glued it all up in pieces, trying to cover the gap with this Babinga here. I will confess again that my joints are not good. I just use CA glue to glue this on. The right thing to do would have been to sand all of the surfaces down perfectly flat and nicely, use wood glue, clamps, and the whole bit to sandwich this stuff together and get it without gaps. There's another little gap over here on this side where the CA glue has hardened there and it's a little bit darker. So on this project, I'm going to say that's okay for now because that's just the way I did it. If I were to do it again, I would be a little more careful with that. So let's put some Danish oil on it. I also usually spill my Danish oil when I'm using it as a finish, but it looks like I did okay today. I don't know how well you can see the grain coming out here and whatever this is, but it's got a lot of purple in it here and some great patterns and colors. I'm really, really enjoying this. This is the surprise of the day. You know, it's that piece of wood you had sitting around, you don't think it's going to amount to much. You want to try something new, like make a big top with just a scrap of wood, and it ends up being something really quite nice. Some beetle grooves on this side that I decided to leave in as well, and to get a little more oil down in there. Alright, so we're all done. I put another coat of Danish oil on this thing and let it soak in. While it was drying, I got to try to remember where I got the idea for this. So I went in and I was looking around on YouTube until I found a video that I remember now seeing that gave me the idea for this. So Chris Pine made some large spinning tops pretty similar to these over a year ago, and I'll link to his video in the description below. So most of the method I used to turn these, really he used a very similar method. So I want to give credit to him for doing this first. I got that inspiration from him. I just couldn't remember before where I'd gotten it, but I went searching for it, and yeah, Chris Pine here on YouTube, and so I'll link to his below. Honestly, I think that his his top spin better than mine, or maybe I'm not very good at spinning it. But so got the Danish oil on here. It looks fantastic. I don't know what this wood is, but it looks great. I'm gonna put up some good still photos at the end, and I'm gonna go and try and turn this thing on video, try and make it spin, so you guys can see how well it goes, and you know how good my top spinning capabilities are. I probably should have my kids do it. I'm sure they could get it to spin a lot better than I can. But I really had a good time making this. I think it's fun. I think it makes an interesting conversation piece anyway, even if it's just sitting on a coffee table like this, because this is a pretty big top. You know, it's got to be 9 inches long at least, and probably 5 inches across. So it's a pretty good sized top. Let's go see how it spins, and I'll put some pictures up. And thanks for joining me here. Please like and subscribe to my channel. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, and hopefully you can join me for some more videos in the future. As usual, you're in charge of safety in your shop, so follow the directions of your shop tools. And if you see anything that's not safe, then you shouldn't do what I'm doing if you don't think it's safe. Thanks a lot. We'll see you guys next time.